Hello, welcome to Connie Martinson Talks Books. Have you, or is there someone in your family with a camcorder? And suddenly, you know, they decided to write a three-act play that they would put on film. And then they said, gee, it's good enough. I'd love to go to a film festival with it. Well, this is the book you get for them. It is called Film Festivals. Almost everything any filmmaker wants to know, this is the book for them. It's written by my two guests, Rona Edwards and Monica Skirbalis. Welcome, ladies.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And it's published by Michael Weiss Productions.
Yeah.
And I have to say about Michael Weiss, it's like he is doing a college or a graduate course on every aspect of film in the books that he's publishing. But in this, he has what I would call a number one bestseller.
Thank you. Thank you very much. We're very, very, very proud of the Complete Filmmaker's Guide to Film Festivals.
Well, you have put everything in, including what most people don't even know. Get clearances. If you're going to shoot something and say, well, this will make a film, here is the book that will tell you what you need, what sort of clearances, and what to take to a festival. So let's begin with, how did it start?
Well, you know, Monica and I have been working together for a very long time. We started teaching at UCLA Extension and basically teaching feature film development, which was the first book that mm-hmm. we wrote, which was that dealt with that. Monica's been very much involved in film festivals since she was in Universal. You could probably talk
about
that.
When I worked at Universal Pictures, I was there for 10 years, and I used to go to the Sundance Film Festival, and I would look for young talent.
Yeah.
And I would go to the film schools, and I would watch the thesis films coming out of all the film schools. And so that's what really got my interest in short films. And then when I left the studio, I got involved with the Big Bear Lake International Film Festival. And so I've been programming films for them for the last 13 years.
But this is everything that most people do not know.
True. This is true. And even people who think they know are going to get something out of this because it gives them a whole roadmap of what they need to do. The interesting thing is when we were writing the other book on feature development and so forth, we started our own workshops online called ESE for Edward Skirbalis mm-hmm. Entertainment. Film workshops online, and we have four signature workshops, one of them being based on the first book, but and another called Creating a Production Company.
Let me just say,
oh, sure.
First book is I Liked It, Didn't Love It.
Right.
Yeah.
Screenplay Development from the Inside Out.
Yeah.
And that's in the second.
And that's in the second edition.
And it's probably going to be in a third very soon.
I hope so.
Yeah.
So after we did that, we created these workshops, and our popular workshops are the one based on the first book, another one called Creating a Production Company, and then the third one being Maneuvering Film Festivals. And actually, that was really the origin of this book. We created this four-week, and would still do it, online a workshop, and from that we decided, you know, everyone that would come and take this workshop would say, if only I had taken this before I submitted my film. If only.
Yeah.
And I said, there's a book in this.
Yeah, it was a natural progression.
It was a natural thing for us to make as our next book. Right. So
doing the research, because not all film festivals are the same. The same way, I did not know, what is that, 400,000?
No, 4,000.
4,000
plus.
4,000 plus.
Yeah, festivals around the world.
Correct.
Yeah, and 164 Jewish film festivals I didn't even know about.
And probably more.
Yeah.
We're speaking, another one has just popped up.
I mean, you can throw a stone and you can hit a film festival, you know, like in Los Angeles every weekend.
And you have to have a certain amount of, and I thought it was great, you go through what you need financially to go to each, or pretty much, festivals.
Yeah, well, you know, it's important, one of the top, I guess, mistakes that filmmakers will make, and we do a whole lecture on the top five mistakes that filmmakers make, you know, upon entering film festivals. One is that they don't plan financially for film festivals in general, and it should be included in their budget right from the get-go when they're producing the movie, not after. You don't want to think about it after the fact. You want to think about it during.
And you also have to think about something as simple as having postcards made.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, that's the marketing is so important.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, business cards, postcards, having a poster.
Yeah.
I mean, it's all so important because you really have to get the word out about your film.
Let's start with the first. What is your log line? What is your film about?
Well, log line is one or two sentences that basically synopsizes your movie. But what people don't realize, they're not easy to write because you want to also whet somebody's appetite. So you want to use that log line not only to pitch your projects, but you also want to use it when, whereas film festivals are concerned, for number one, submitting your film, number two, the festival program.
Yeah, it has to entice the reader who's reading the program guide to want to see your film. And so you need to capture your film, you know, in this one or two sentences very quickly.
Because ultimately you want to get an audience for your film.
And there is, you said there is online a website that you can almost register your film on.
Yes, withoutabox.com.
Most filmmakers will know about withoutabox.com. It's a pretty much an all-encompassing site for free for the filmmakers, not free for the festivals. And you can basically not only upload your entry forms, your log line, your cast and crew, your, basically your press kit and so forth up online that any programmer from any festival can have access to if they're part of Without a Box, and I would venture to say everyone is part of it. But there's also a European version of it, a smaller version called the Short Film Depot, and some festivals only use that one that are in Europe as well.
About Cannes Film Festival has a short film. I only thought it was for big names, Tom Cruise or Clint Eastwood having a film there. No, there's a lot more to it, including writing.
Yeah, there's a short film corner, and they have close to 3,000 films in a market there. And what you do is there's about 50 cubicles, and you sit down at these cubicles with a computer and headphones, and you sit there and you just like go through all the films, and you watch all the films. I work with the American Pavilion's Emerging Filmmaker Showcase down at the Cannes Film Festival, and so it's like, you know, you can go and find all of the films that are under the umbrella of the American Pavilion. It's just a great way to, you know, see films.
And also, that's a way of networking.
Well, networking is probably one of the mistakes a lot of filmmakers make as well, not knowing how to do so, not knowing how to have that calling card, not just promoting themselves and their film, but maybe their next film, or meeting other filmmakers with like mind that maybe they'll end up working together in the future with. So there's a lot that you can accomplish at a film festival besides just the film that you might have or have in the film festival, or else as just a festival goer, someone who loves films.
Screenwriters can have a great time at film festivals.
Well, where you said at Sundance is a screenwriters award.
Well, they have the, at Sundance they have the screenwriters lab. And they do give out a screenwriting award.
I'm sure I saw it here. Was it one of the other festivals?
Well, there's a lot of festivals have other components to it. They will have the film part. They will have maybe a screenwriting competition. They might even, like South by Southwest, has a whole music component as well. So they're a lot of fun to go to just to have fun and see films that, you know, a lot of times film festivals will present films that you wouldn't normally get to see. They may not always be the Hollywood big tent poles that are out there. Some of them will have them as opening night films or closing night films. But all the films in between are films from all over the world that you might not get a chance to ever really see. And it's a great experience to mingle with those filmmakers from all over the world.
Now, you've been accepted. Now what? And this is, do you bring your lawyer? Do you?
You know, it depends on the film festival. I would say if you're going to Cannes or Berlin or Toronto or Sundance, it would be very good to make sure you have a little bit of a team. If you have a film in one of those festivals, a publicist, a lawyer, you know, because you're wanting to sell distribution.
And you want as much support around you as you can to help out there and talk up your film.
So, yes, but the other thing is bringing cast members, you know, especially if you have anyone of note, you might want that one notable cast member with you because that will garner publicity and attention, and that's basically how do you stand out from the pack.
Now, you've been accepted, but you're not living in Hollywood, you're not living in New York, you're living in Oshkosh. How do you get on television there that will be noticed?
Well, that's one of the, that's one of the things that I think is really important for filmmakers to know is that once you've been accepted, you should call the local radio station, call the local newspaper, and send them an EPK, you know, electronic press kit. and you know, just really do some footwork to get yourself in front of the media there, so they will showcase you.
Most smaller town festivals, in particular, have their own little networks and their own newspapers. And newspapers, whether they're online or they're in print, hopefully still remaining in print, they're hungry for material. So if you come out with a great press release that you've written about your film, they may just print it verbatim because they're hungry for material. Or in the case of an interview show like this, for example, you could find someone who does a show, a weekly show or whatever, on one of those stations, who's also hungry for new guests, and say, I'm going to be there early. I can do it, an appearance for you. Or a radio show. There's radios, local radio stations everywhere that have interview format shows. And everyone's hungry for good stories. And if it's a good film or a good premise for film, it's going to be easy to talk
and
to that
And don't
person.
Forget, there's something called the Internet.
The Internet's...
Website.
Absolutely.
Facebook.
Blogging.
Twitter.
Blogging. Yeah. So, and that's another thing a filmmaker needs to do, too, is to keep engaging their audience even that way.
But this is also the money. What's it going to cost to sort of submit your new film?
It sort of depends on the festival.
Yeah,
you have that here. I mean, it could be anywhere from $35 up to $100, depending on the film festival.
So,
I mean, it's best to get in as the early bird deadline rate.
Yeah, and you better remember that networking is king.
Absolutely.
Networking is absolutely king, and there's so many ways to do it, because we always say that there's more than just one goal when it comes to a film festival for the filmmaker. If you're a writer, you might want to find that wonderful director or producer. And if you're the director, you want to find material. So you want to meet up with writers, or you want to meet that producer that might see your vision.
It will be hard for the camera to pick up, but there is a page here about what you need to check off in submitting to the festival.
Correct, yes.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you want to talk a little bit about that, or?
Yeah. I mean, it's the checklist there, and what we have is you want the name of the film festival, and then you want to have the date of the festival, and then the deadline dates.
Yeah.
And then be able to target what dates, what film festivals, what film festival you may want to try to premiere at.
And also, you want to look at the late deadlines, the early deadlines. Each one costs a little more as you get closer to the festival, so you do want to try and get it in on the early deadline to save money. But you also want to look and see what time of the year those festivals are, because you do have to plan, as Monica said, certain festivals require a premiere.
Yeah.
And that means strategy. So you have to create a strategy for yourself when it comes to film
festivals. There's also, which of these 1,000 festivals are you going to submit to?
Yeah, the Academy Qualifying Film Festivals is a great way to target your first tier of film festivals, because if you win at an Academy Qualifying Film Festival, then your film festival will have the opportunity to go into a pool to be considered for the Oscars.
Do you know, I never
that
knew that till I read
film.
This.
This is for short film.
Yeah. So that was really amazing. The other is, when you have submitted, have you looked at where winners of that festival have gone after? Oh. Did anybody buy their film?
Yes, most of them do get bought. Short films have a harder time in the United States of distribution, but they do get distribution as interstitials on like the Sundance Channel and IFP, IFC, I should say, not IFP. That's another organization.
Airlines.
No, IFP is.
Airlines.
Airlines as well. Yes, but in Europe and in Asia in particular, short film is very king. They get programmed a lot all over broadcast television. They get programmed before feature films as well in movie theaters.
Really?
So you can actually make a little bit of money.
Yeah, you're teaching in Singapore.
I am teaching at Chapman University, Singapore, correct.
Yeah.